told me couldn't doubt it. You couldn't understand it. Branded, sent the first kick flip, landed. Labeled a misfit, abandoned. His neighbors couldn't stand it, so he was banished to the park. Started in the morning, one stopped after dark. Yeah, when they said it's getting late in here, so I'm sorry, young man, there's no escaping here. So we kick.
Will be the most difficult obstacle in teaching education.
Not knowing what's coming. You look at those the park exams now, there's a big controversy about them. You look about, you know, all standardized testing. You look about, you know, you look at, you know, different regulations that teachers face and different, you know, circumstances that they face, and just not knowing what is coming. I mean, I almost feel like they're constricting, you know, education in a sense, and unfortunately teachers have to teach around that. I mean, you look at news reports, and you know half the year is looked at focusing on the park exam. I mean, have, you know, X amount of time to teach certain subjects to make students well-rounded. And I feel like that's what being a teacher is all about, is being well-rounded. So in regards to obstacles that I may face in the future, I feel like teaching around regulations may be the hardest thing that I...
Rob, why do you want to teach high school?
I want to teach high school because, you know, I believe their awareness is just a little higher than you know, middle school and elementary school. And you can have in-depth, you know, discussions and conversations and higher level learning with high school kids. And you can get into more, you know, in detail and depth. And it just encompasses more of what I want to teach. You know, it's hard to teach U.S. history or European history at an elementary level. But, you know, once you get to high school, you know, the horizon truly broadens, and it's just, you know, really what I want to do.
Influence you to become a teacher?
You know, I started with the wrestling program and the football program as well that I coach, and just to see the smile and joy on the kids' faces once they progress from step one to step two, is what really kind of ushered me into the teaching realm and. What I wanted to do, because I wanted to see that, I wanted to see the kids progress, and I wanted to see the kids do better and do well, and that's what really gives me the inspiration to become a teacher.
How did the people in the video inspire you to choose the goals you wish to reach?
Well, first and foremost, there's Randall Fuchs, and Mr. Fuchs was my 11th grade history teacher, and he you know, he inspired me to be great. He inspired, you know, after I took his final, he asked me, you know, how much I studied, and I said zero. I said I didn't study at all, and he said, you got a 97. And I said, well, that's pretty good if you ask me. He goes, you got the highest grade in the class. And he goes, just imagine if you actually worked hard, and you actually worked to be good, you can get 100, no problem. And it kind of woke me up to realize that if I work hard and I do what I need to do, and I want to be great, you know, I can do unbelievable things. The next on the list is Philip Dolce. Mr. Dolce was a professor of mine at Bergen Community College prior to going to Ramapo, and he influenced me on really becoming a teacher. He helped me through the, you know, the footworks of being a teacher, and what it takes in order to reach kids, and he's just a big influence on my life. The next is Craig Nielsen, and Mr. Nielsen, he knows how to win. He's a two-time coach of the decade in football at Pascack Valley, and he took the Mahwah softball team to unbelievable heights when he took over the program. And it's an honor to work with Mr. Nielsen. He has an unbelievable work ethic. You know, he has, you know, all his programs are successful, and when it comes to coaching, he's the marquee. You know, he's the highest point you can be, and he just knows how to do things correctly, and it's a great, great influence on my life. Mr. Heitman, I'd go to war for. He's my wrestling coach in high school, and wrestling is a very, very tough sport, and it's very hard to control the kids. But Mr. Heitman was the greatest guy I've ever met in terms of sports. You know, next on the list is my dad. And, you know, my dad's been obviously in my life since the day I was born, but my dad's taught me one thing that I don't think, you know, anyone else could ever teach me, and that's, you know, to anticipate the actions of others, you know, that way you don't have to worry about yourself. And, you know, it just kind of echoed in my life that if I focus on, you know, appeasing those around me, and you can relate that to kids, and, you know, appeasing to their needs, you don't have to worry about yourself. You know, if you appease to the children's needs, you know, you don't have to worry about yourself in any regard. At least is my grandfather, Tom Doyle. He actually never graduated high school, which is kind of funny, you know, mentioning teaching in higher level education. But his work ethic was just unbelievable. He worked every day of his life. He was a painter, you know, and that's a demanding job, and he never ceased, you know, his job until the work was done. And I think that can echo in my life in the regards that I shouldn't stop as a teacher until I know that all of my children, all the students that I have, are 100% satisfied with their education. And if I stop prior to that, you know, I'm not doing my job as a teacher. You know, I'm paid, you know, or I will be paid to educate. And if I don't complete that goal, you know, I shouldn't even accept the money. You know, it's just that simple. And I think my grandpa has one of the biggest influences on my life, because his work ethic was truly, truly amazing. And he just refused to stop and refused to end his work until it was 100% completed.